Hello, Ducks fans, hockey fans in Orange County, California, United States, Canada, Finland, Sweden, and all over the world. Hope you guys are doing great, staying safe, staying healthy, and keeping each other company. And also, happy Thursday to everyone. So, our team has began their quest for the Stanley Cup and their season, the 28th season. Third short season in this era of the pandemic that we are all enduring at this moment, and trying to support each other through these challenging times. And let me give you my impression of our Ducks for the past seven games that I've saw, and I've looked at the videos of our team, and I'll give you my first, my personal impressions, okay? First things first, I was not surprised that the Ducks came out slow. I mean, in the history of our team, they have been slow starters. I mean, we should not basically panic or freak out of why the Ducks lose this game and that game, and why they cannot able to score. I mean, let's put it this way. For the past 27 years, we know this team have always been slow to starters. But what makes this season more extraordinary is the fact that, one, it's 56 games. Two, it's during the pandemic. And three, of course, they haven't played for nearly a year. So, watching them from game one until, like, the seventh game, like, against Arizona, I can tell that they were trying to get into that routine. They were trying to get into that, that battle mentality, that fighting spirit that they have. And when you're not playing a game or not in that routine that you are so accustomed to, since our Ducks are so accustomed to, and the other NHL teams and hockey teams around the world are so accustomed to, you're bound to see some sluggishness, some more pass-oriented, that sort of thing. I'm not making excuses, but that's how I see in how this team is doing. And another thing that I've noticed was the They are showing that flash of brilliance. Their flash of offensive prowess that as the minutes go by, as the games go by. I mean, from Vegas, I could tell that, you know, they were trying to get something going. I mean, they were trying to get something going. They were trying to get that first goal, but unfortunately, when the habit the Ducks have is always letting the other team score the goal, it's kind of, we all got to have to tolerate that. But then again, it's our team, and they have, and it's a bad habit that they need to break. So, all in all, and I keep on saying all in all, the Ducks being very slow start is not thing to be to panic about. At this point of this short season, the Ducks are 3-2-2 with 8 points. They are, after 7 games played, they have scored 12 goals for, and had 14 goals scored against them, tied for 3rd place in the Honda West Division. Now, so far, I mean, we should not be disappointed. We should not be in panic. I mean, if history tells us, the history of our team, the Ducks' history tells us, slow starts doesn't mean that they're a bad team. Look at the 2002-2003 season, for example. The Ducks were pretty bad in October, and they went to one game away from winning the Stanley Cup. And I can name several examples of slow starts where the Ducks would have a slow start, then they will make the Stanley Cup playoffs. So it's in the seasons, and we and you guys know this too. You know this, what I'm talking about. So tied for third place, and I mean it's good. It's a good start. It's something to build on. I mean, something that needs to be corrected after nearly a year without playing hockey. So another thing to basically point out is the fact that the Ducks once again have problems scoring goals. I mean, you know, when you're scoring like one or two goals a game and more than just three goals, it leads to questions. It leads to real honest questions about, okay, how you're going to get this the offense to jump start. It's always simple. You know, you have to have the youth and the offense, I mean, and the veteran experience of this team working hand in hand. I mean, kudos to Dallas Eakins, like the Ducks head coach, for calling out the vets who need to step up, because they're in that role of mentorship for the next generation of Ducks players to know what it means when you wear the Ducks D, or of course, the good old-fashioned duck mask right here, and what it all means to put it on, that uniform. And that is very important. That's very important. But despite the offensive lacking or I wouldn't point away they were lacking effort there. It's snake bite, you know. It's kind of like that scoring drought, you know. Everyone's looking out for that goal. And in the previous game where the Ducks won, 1-0 over Arizona, was an example. The Ducks are finding their rhythm, finding their groove, finding that gel, getting together, realizing what needs to be done to hopefully have a surge, which we all want them to see. I mean, setting things right now is important, but also giving Ducks fans and the people of Anaheim and Orange County something to look forward to, something to have to be inspired and motivated and unite. So, speaking of the Ducks 1-0 shutout win, I have to say this really personally and really something that needs to be talked about, and that is the milestones we are approaching. Now, if most of you have seen one of my previous vlogs, Ducks Fan Vlog 16, I talk about the Ducks history and what it means and why it's so important to all of us, especially with witnessing many historical moments, highs and lows, and some milestones. This season, we may be seeing two milestones being tied and broken. One of them is John Gibson recording his 21st shutout and his 21st shutout as a Duck. Now, I just want to tell you something. Gibson is, how do I put this way? He's at least 11 shutouts away from tying the all-time shutout record by Ducks legendary goalie Jean-Sebastien Jaguar. An accomplishment that still stands to this day, but something that Jiggy paved the road for. And it's something that we should look forward to. Can he be on projected path to tie and maybe break Jiggy's record? Who knows? I mean, this is nothing against Jean-Sebastien Jaguar. He made his mark, paved the way, and immortalized his name to all Ducks fans and the people of Anaheim and Orange County and hockey fans in that area. And whether or not if Gibson ties it or breaks it, it's always important to remember who set that bar. And Jiggy set that bar for Ducks goalies like Gibson and others, and who knows, future Ducks goalies down the road. Another milestone we should look at through is that is Ryan Getzlaf, Captain Ryan Getzlaf, the longest serving Duck on our team and the longest serving Ducks draftee from 2005 now. I mean, thinking about that, thinking about Getzlaf, you know, he was still that fresh face, full set of hair, young guy, come from Calgary, you know, and now he's bald, like me, and he's mentoring the next generation of Ducks. Now, I'm bringing this up because he is 20 points away from tying the all-time Ducks points by a player. Now that all-time points total is 988. That's held by, can you guess, Ducks legend number 8, the Finnish Flash, Teemu Selänne. Can he break that record? Can he tie that record? I believe he can do it. Whether he is delayed by injuries or who knows. One thing is important, is that is, with Getzlaf 20 points away from tying the Ducks' all-time points leader, Teemu Selänne, the Ducks' legend and Finnish Flash, and Gibson, at least 11 shutouts away from tying Jaguar's record for most shutouts by a Ducks goalie, it gives an incentive for us to look forward to each season. I mean, for us, witnessing this, it's very sentimental. It's very important because we see milestones being accomplished, achieved, milestones broken, history made many times by our team, by our Ducks. Whether it be on, whether we watch it live on TV, attend it live at the game, even though I understand that the majority of you would love to see Gibson and Getzlaf accomplish that feat, and I understand, it's always important to keep an eye on that, and that's an incentive for this season, for this short season. And many of you I know miss hockey, miss meeting your friends, miss like hanging out and enjoying the love of that sport. And I know, I understand. I mean, every day, every game that I have watched, I have listened on internet radio, I have always wondered how my friends and acquaintances are doing. And I know that this team is there to help all of you and to help me to ensure, like, there is a positive distraction amidst all the craziness that's been going on. I understand that. And this season, even though it's short, we get to see some milestones within reach being tied and probably being broken by Ducks captain Ryan Getzlaf and goalie John Gibson. Now, going forward, how the Ducks will do still remains to be answered. I always go with a wait-and-see approach. It's always important to go with a wait-and-see approach. If you are into the predictions, if you believe the Ducks will finish dead last or whatever, hey, to each their own. It's your choice, man. It's democracy. We are all entitled to how we feel is the best path for our team. And that's the main thing. That is the main thing. Okay? Each game, whether we win or lose of this season, is very important. It provides us with a positive distraction. Okay? Provides us a meaning of getting together, talk about hockey, talk about sports, talk about, hey, why Getzlaf is passing too much to... Is John Gibson trying to be John Sebastian Gare? That's the main thing. And also, we cannot, how do I say this? We cannot give in to these so-called predictions. We cannot give in these predictions. These, because I don't agree with predictions. You know, you can predict, like, you know, who's going to win the Stanley Cup, okay? Or who's going to win the MVP, you know? Like, let's be honest. The only way that can happen is we got to wait and see. We got to wait and see how the season progress. And that is to be very, very clear, because we need to understand one thing. Whatever this team does, okay? Because right now, the Ducks are 3-2-2, 8 points, tied for third place in the Honda West Division, which, as I said a few minutes ago, they're building on that. And hopefully they can surge forward and lay a path of destruction. It can provide, basically, a sense of distraction, but also a sense of a bridge to bring people together, because as much as look, even though that they're in 7 games in, let's hope they continue this momentum, because I know that we need the Ducks as more than ever before, and whatever weeks, the months lay ahead, I hope one day that when all this is over, I can come and see all of you. And maybe video the experience of the Honda Center and how it has become part of the civic culture of Orange County. I mean, to be honest with you, as many of you do miss Ducks Hockey and would love to see Getzlaf and Gibson reach that milestone and become an equal to Ducks legend Tamas Solani and Jay Jaguar, we have to wait and see, because what it comes down to is that this season is our lifeline. This season is something we should look forward to and enjoy, and we should leave all our worries and our fear and our despair outside. And we unite around the Ducks banner, which is this. And I know you guys are not doing well, but keep the faith, okay? Keep the faith. And have hope. And keep each other company. Keep each other stay strong together. Okay? Because this season is important. And I can't stress that enough. I may have said that enough many times. But we have to stick together. We have to be strong together. And we have to be united together. Like that hashtag, fly together. Well, guess what? We're all like a Ducks flock. The Ducks make a community. Ducks fans, we are a community. In whether or not if you live in the OC, Orange County, California, or everywhere. We try to keep each other strong. Okay? Like a flock, like a team, like a community. And the Ducks, who knows? If they surge this up, maybe we can all come together and cross our fingers and see this team achieve something that we hope that they can bring honor, glory, and a lot of happiness to us all. That is what we need. That is what this team is for. Till then, I'll see you guys soon.